Earl Albers also reached out to Berlin's needy children. He helped countless children, including my own mother. Welcome. In 1948, on Christmas Day, my mother became the first German to receive a care package from the U.S. commander of the American zone in Germany, General Lucius D. Clay, during the Berlin airlift. Sergeant Major Albers had instilled a renewed sense of confidence in his so-called Berlin kids, including my mother. Welcome. When she wrote to thank General Clay for the care package, she also asked him to help her obtain a visa to the United States to study English. He responded to her letter and intervened on her behalf, and she became one of the first German post-war exchange students to America. Upon arrival, my mother met with President Truman. And all of this occurred because of the initial act of kindness of one man, Sergeant Major Earl Albers.
But tonight, we're here because a man brought a piece of the wall over. And it's much bigger than the piece that I received from one of the kids that was in Berlin while it was being torn down. The four Allied nations agreed that they wanted to help Germany out after the war. Unfortunately, the Soviet powers wanted to do it in a different way than the other three. And it was evident from the very beginning that the Soviets not only wanted to control the property and the industry, but they were really interested in what the people were doing and where they were. It became known that the Soviets would not allow anybody to enter West Berlin unless they passed through certain checkpoints. And they were supposed to return the same day they left through the same point. They still disappeared from the east and came to the west. Then it became necessary to apply for a pass, not a visa, but a pass. And even we military from the Allied countries had to have passes if we wanted to go from Berlin to the American zone or to the French zone. Those were easy for us to get. They always were approved. But for the native Eastern Germans, that was not so easy. You applied for a pass, and you were told how many of the family could go across at a given time, and they were supposed to return the same day. I think that they felt that if it kept part of the family in the East, there would be no one flee. But there still came stories in the newspapers and the magazines, and we heard rumors that people left the East. That's what happened before the war. And then the wall, of course, came into being. When I looked at this piece of the wall behind me earlier today and again this evening, I realized this is an excellent place for it to be standing. The young people that come here and all others that visit and pass by should stop and I hope think about all the misery that was brought upon those who tried to get out of East Berlin before the wall finally fell. It's hard to believe that anybody thought it would be a success in the first place. Mankind should not build walls of any kind to separate us from one another. I recall one time a man that I wrote letters to in Czechoslovakia, when he found out that I could write German, he wrote a letter and told me he was so glad that I spoke German, and he spoke several languages. He said, so many times as you can speak another language, so many times are you another person. That's quite true. If you really speak a language from the heart, you have a different views on things than you would if you thought about it in another tongue. I think this wall will serve a purpose, and I hope it stands long, being a memory to everyone that all walls have been unsuccessful in the past, and why should we think they would help us in the future? And with that, I'm going to stop.
Guten Abend. Good evening. Distinguished guests, liebe Landsleute, dear friends, I start with a confession. I have a feeling tonight is a time for emotions. Gail Halverson, Earl Albers, I'm deeply honored and moved to be here with you tonight. You should know I was born after the war, and I'm the first generation of Germans who didn't have a war in their lifetime. The first generation to play baseball. In a way, this remembers me of the very old Roman concept, panem et circenses, which literally translated means bread and games. In this case, it meant chocolate and baseball. Well, this is what people want and need, and that's what cements friendship. And now I have a little surprise, and I would like to ask you, Earl Albers, to come forward, because I said Gail has so many decorations. We didn't know of you that you will be here tonight, but I brought you some very nice token of our appreciation and friendship. It's the Federal Republic of Germany Friendship Award, and it reads, presented to Earl Albers on November 17, 2010, in recognition of your efforts on behalf of German-American relations, in recognition of your endeavors in fostering and sustaining friendship between the Federal Republic of Germany and the United States of America, presented by Klaus Schariot, Ambassador of the Federal Republic of Germany. Congratulations.
Whereas Sergeant Major Earl Albers served his country with distinction in the United States Army during World War II, representing democracy at its best and ultimately helping to plant the seeds of the peaceful revolution that took place in Berlin over 40 years later. And whereas Sergeant Major Earl Albers embodies Chapman University's mission of global citizenship through his service in the United States Army and his role in creating the German Youth Activities Organization, a safe haven for young people in post-war Germany to heal their emotional wounds and teach them about democracy. Therefore, and I speak here for the President, I, James L. Doty, President of Chapman University, do hereby issue this proclamation honoring Sergeant Major Earl Albers for his noble deeds working with young people in post-war Berlin, dated the 17th day of November 2010. Thank you very much.